So today's topic is accounts of holding company or of the parent company. This is a very relevant topic and it's a significant one because you have one question from this complete topic coming in your exams. So the whole study of this accounting of holding company or of parent company is divided into three parts. First of all, we shall be studying terms and provisions. Basic terms involved in the accounts of holding company or parent company, like what is holding company, subsidiary company, group company, etc. So all these terms and the main provisions under which these accounts are prepared, that we will be studying in the first part. Second part of this topic is preparation of the consolidated balance sheet of a holding company and its subsidiary company. So this is the practical part of this chapter, wherein we shall be studying how to prepare consolidated balance sheet. This includes basic principles of consolidation. So first of all, we will be studying the basic principles of consolidation, wherein we will be studying how to prepare a consolidated statement in simple terms. Now, a practical question involves three steps procedure: working notes, making of the balance sheet, and notes to accounts. Once we are clear about the basic problems, how to do all these three steps in a simple consolidation problem, then we will be introducing adjustments. There are 8 adjustments in all: elimination of common transactions, unrealized profit on common stock, bonus shares, and so on. So once a simple problem is clear, we know how to form the accounts and how to prepare various notes, etc., then one by one these adjustments will be included. So then we will get to know the comprehensive problems. Once the practical part is known, we are in a better position to appreciate and understand merits and demerits of consolidation and the guiding principles. Consolidation is guided by accounting standard 21 and Ind accounting standard 110. So once we are clear with the practical part, the relevant provisions of the accounting standards will be studied. So in all, 3 parts are there. So this topic is to be covered in this. Let us start with the first part, that is main terms and provisions. Like in this topic, we are saying that this is accounts of holding company or of parent company. So the very first thing that comes to our mind is, what is a holding or a parent company? As per Section 2, subsection 46 of Indian Companies Act, a holding company is a company which has one or more subsidiary companies. So as such, in this definition, nothing much is defined. It simply says that if a company is having a subsidiary company, then it is referred as a holding company. So this brings us to the other definition, that is subsidiary company. So what is a subsidiary company? Because once we know that it is a subsidiary company, then we can identify its holding company also. Now, as per the Section 2, subsection 87 of Companies Act, it's a company in which the holding company controls the composition of board. That is, if in a company, the other company is in a position to appoint directors or to remove them, that is, they can control the composition of the board, then we can say that the such company which is being controlled is a subsidiary company, whereas the other company which is controlling the composition is the holding company. Another way of acquiring control over the other company, subsidiary company, is controlling more than 50% of the voting power. As we all know that the voting power in case of company limited by shares lies in the hands of equity shareholders. So if a company is holding more than 50% of equity share capital, then this company is called the holding company, and the company whose shares are acquired by such holding company will be referred as subsidiary company. So in all, we can say that a subsidiary company is one in which either the other company is controlling the composition of the board, or it is controlling more than 50% of voting power, that is equity share capital. So then the company which is having the control will be referred as holding company, and the company which is being controlled is called a subsidiary company. Now this also includes one more provision, that a holding company need not to acquire the control on its own. It can acquire the control indirectly also from the other subsidiary companies. Like take a case that there is a company A Limited which is controlling B Limited by purchasing their more than 50% of the voting power share capital, that is equity share capital. Now consider a case wherein B company is controlling another C company, by purchasing shares in that company, so automatically C company becomes subsidiary of A company. So B is the actual subsidiary because they have acquired control there directly, but C company comes under the control of A Limited indirectly through their own subsidiary company. So this is also referred as a deemed subsidiary company. Now the holding company and subsidiary companies together or collectively are called group. That is, a group implies a holding company along with all its subsidiary companies. So we know the terms now that a holding company is the one which is purchasing shares in the other company to acquire control of that company through the board, and the other company is referred as subsidiary company, and collectively they will be called group, that is group of holding and all its subsidiary companies. Now the next thing is that if we are working for holding and subsidiary companies, then what are the relevant provisions? Now as per Indian Companies Act 2013, section 129, it specifies that a holding company is required to prepare consolidated financial statements along with their own financial statements and present them before their shareholders in the annual general meeting. As we all know that companies are required to prepare and present their financial statements before their annual general meeting in the shareholders. So along with their own financial statements, they are required to prepare consolidated financial statements. Financial statements includes four things: balance sheet, statement of profit and loss, cash flow statement, notes, statements and explanatory schedules. Consolidated financial statements will imply all these statements by combining holding company and subsidiary company's results together. So they are to prepare consolidated balance sheet, that is a balance sheet of their own plus the balance sheet of the subsidiary companies, consolidated statement of profit and loss, consolidated cash flow statement and relevant notes, statements, etc. So this brings us to this topic, that is consolidation of the results and of the balance sheet of holding and subsidiary company. This has become mandatory with the Indian Companies Act 2013, and hence the need for preparation of the consolidated financial statements. Now, consolidated financial statements implies statements of the group as a whole. That is, on one side you have statements of holding company, you have statements of subsidiary companies, and when the statements are combined, that is taking the holding and subsidiary company as one enterprise, then these combined statements are referred as consolidated statements. Now it is relevant here to state that although we have four different type of components of consolidated financial statements, but our topic majorly deals with the consolidated balance sheet. So in this chapter we will be studying preparation of consolidated balance sheet. Now there is another term which is relevant here. It is called minority's interest. Now what is meant by minorities? Basically, when we are saying that in consolidation there is a company which is acquiring control or which has acquired control of another company by purchasing their voting power, that is by purchasing their equity share capital above 50%. Now more than 50% is held by the holding company, but the some part of share capital is still left which is not owned by holding company. So this is this capital is owned by the other shareholders which are not a part of holding company. So the other shareholders are called minorities, and their share in the company is called minority's interest. Take a case of a subsidiary company which is having, say, share capital of 1000 equity shares of 100 rupees each, that is 1 lakh rupees. Now holding company, in order to acquire the shares of this company, to get the control over this, they acquire 80% of the shares of this company, which implies out of 1000 they have acquired 80%, that is 800 shares. So 200 shares are still lying in the hands of some other individuals. Now those individuals are referred as minorities. So in a way we can say that in subsidiary company, holding company is having a control of 80%, and minorities means the remaining shareholders, they are having 20% of the share capital of this company. Now the share of minorities in the capital as well as in the profits, reserves or in the losses, etc. of the subsidiary company all combined together is referred as minorities interest. Because when we buy shares in a company, we are not only buying their share capital, but we are also getting a right over their reserves, surplus, profits, etc. So the minorities which are holding share capital in a company, they are not only holding the capital, but they are also holding a share in the profits, in the results of that company. So minorities interest is the part of the net assets and net result of business operations which is not owned by holding company. So it represents that part of subsidiary company which is held by other shareholders referred as minorities, and their combined value is called non-controlling interest or minorities interest. Now, while preparing consolidated balance sheet, it is mandatory that minorities interest must be calculated and it should be shown in the consolidated balance sheet after shareholders' funds. So when we are combining the two balance sheets and preparing consolidated balance sheet, then in the consolidated balance sheet, one new term will come, that is minorities interest, which will be calculated and it will be shown just after shareholders' funds in that. So that completes the first topic, that is terms and provisions. That is basic terms and provisions. We have studied holding company, subsi company, group, consolidated statements, relevant provisions of the section 129 of Companies Act and minorities interest. So in the next class, we will be studying preparation of consolidated balance sheet of holding company and subsidiary company. Now while solving practical questions, we have to remember one thing, that these practical problems exclude intercompany holdings. That is, we are working for only one-way control, wherein holding company is buying shares of subsidiary company, and the case where subsidiary company has also invested into certain shares of holding company, they are excluded. Secondly, in solving practical problems, we will be working for only one subsidiary company with the holding company. So the practical problems that we will be solving here, they will be worked under one first assumption, that only one subsidiary company will be considered. Secondly, we are to exclude intercompany holdings. That is, when subsidiary company is buying shares in the holding company, so that part is also excluded. So excluding these two things, rest will be covered in the preparation of consolidated balance sheet. Now when we are to prepare consolidated balance sheet, while preparing that balance sheet, we need to remember a few things, and the most important thing is that while solving the practical problems, we must be familiar with the format of the balance sheet of the company as per Schedule 3 of the Companies Act. Because balance sheet is to be prepared strictly as per the schedule. So the presentation of all the information and relevant accounts must be as per the schedule. So it will be appropriate that before you look for the next class, you have a reading of the format of balance sheet in Schedule 3rd of the Companies Act, that you can see either through the Companies Act schedule, and a link for the same and a standard format of the balance sheet is given on our Facebook page. So you can click on the links given below in the description column, and then you can read the format of the balance sheet, because once we are familiar with the balance sheet format, then only we can solve the practical problems. So don't forget to read the format of balance sheet as per the Schedule 3rd of the Companies Act. Thank you.